in this cell culture analysis, we have got some micrographs of the cells. Now, these micrographs of the cells, they need to be highlighted for analysis at a later stage. So, what happens is that we are having the original image, then we go for the adding a copy. Okay, so this copy, it goes in a buffer. Okay, so it stays in a buffer. Okay, then we go for the smoothing using a medium filter. So original image is being smoothed over here. Okay, even though it is appearing that it is going in a straight line, but it is not happening in a straight line. Okay, so the smoothing is happening using the median filter. This is smoothing median using a 3x3 kernel. Okay, using a 3x3 kernel, the smoothing is being carried out. Now, after this, we go for the conclusion, highlighting of the details, just like in our previous case. We go for this highlighting. Okay. So, see, there is certain changes. So, the in this area, in, on the right hand side, our details have been enhanced. Then, just like in the previous case, we go for the thresholding. Okay. Then again, remove small objects. Now, the problem is that if you look over here, some of the objects, they are conjoined. To remove the to separate these conjoined particles, we go for the separate objects. Okay, so separate objects. So if you see, some of the conjoined particles over here, they have been separated on the right hand side image. Okay, then we do labeling. Now, labeling allows us to see whether the two particles which are conjoined, whether they are still together or they have been separated properly. Okay, so in this case, see, these conjoined particles has not been separated, but over here these conjoined particles has been separated. Okay, using the separate object. So if you still want that, you want to separate this thing also, then again you have to go back and again change the parameters over here. Maybe you want to increase the iterations. So it was previously 3. So if you see, when we are increasing this thing, see over here they are getting separated. So the other it is not visible over there properly. So if you look into your computer screen, you'll find the other particles, they are getting degraded. So we will keep it as 2, and whatever errors are there, we will accept that. Okay. So only one particle it is having this pattern. Now, why labeling is done? Labeling is done in an binary image, and you need to find out over there whether the particles which are there, whether they are separate particles or not. Okay. To identify those things, you have to do this. Then gradient out, you have already done how to find out the outer gradient. So that is calculated. Then multiply. Okay, so you are multiplying with a constant of 255. So your pixels are being highlighted over here. These outer cells, they are being highlighted. Then add to buffer. Okay, you have created a copy. Now that is being added up over here using this image. Your multiply constant image, this is being added up over here. Now you see, at this last stage, you are getting an image with its borders which are being highlighted. Okay, and all the conjoined cells, they have been separated. Okay, so this is how you can identify and identify cells and highlight them. And if there are some conjoined cells, because it may so happen that one cell is, you have taken the image such that one cell is there, over that another overlapping cell is there. So if you do the measurement on the conjoined cells, then your measurement will be wrong, okay, or the counting will be wrong. So you might be interested in separating and then highlighting and then doing the analysis, okay. In the blister pack inspection, what happens is that here you are having blister packs with some what you call two colors are there. Okay, these capsules are there which are having white and green colors, and you want to find out the location of these colors. So this is done by color pattern matching. Okay, so what it does is that in the color pattern matching, you need it finds out the hue, HSI. Okay, so those are color spaces which we will be discussing in the next class. So what happens is that we all know that our TV screen monitors and all these things, they are generating colors by RGB model, color model. But in industrial scale, for the identification of colors, we usually employ HSI model, hue, saturation and intensity. Okay, and hue, it carries the information about the color. Okay, so what happens is that if you take the image at a particular lighting condition, and if you take another image at another lighting condition, so what happens is that your the second image what you have taken, it may be darker or it may be brighter. So in that case, what will happen? You are not able to judge the color properly. Even though the color is same, you will be having a different perception that the second image is either darker or more brighter, and the color will also look different. So this is one of the major disadvantage of the RGB model. So to circumvent that, HSI model is being used for this color pattern matching applications. Okay, so from here what it does is that it locates the colors which are present, okay, and then it counts it. So in this strip we are having 10 capsules, okay. So it locates it and it counts how many color locations it has formed. So in this way the automated inspection of the blister packs are being carried out. Okay, so this is the original image, then it goes for the fine dental floss base. Okay, so over here if you see on the left hand side, we are having a template. Okay, we are having a template. Okay, see template image, right? Now this template image, it is having a pattern. What is a pattern? Pattern is an arrangement of pixels in such a fashion that it is giving you a kind of information about a shape. Okay, so it is basically a variation of the light intensity across an image. Okay, so what we do over here is that we find we have to give a template. Okay, so once you have created a template, then you go for the pattern matching. So what it will do, it will do autocorrelation of the template on the original image, and it will find the location where it has got a maximum autocorrelation, and it will say that at this location this template is present. Okay, then from here we need to set coordinates. Now after coordinate, then we go for this this measurement of this one or the intensity of this one. So this is the dental floss. So it finds out the quality of this thing from the intensity level. Okay. So what is the length? What is the area of the floss? It tries to find out that. So what happens? This is the holder of the dental floss. You first create a template. You find out what is the coordinate system of the dental floss and where you have to look at, look for. So after you have decided that, you go to the measurement area, and in the measurement area, you look for the properties of the things. Now suppose you have designed something, say you have designed a suture, and you have to analyze the suture. How will you do that? Suppose you are designing a suture which should be say 10 micron thick. How will you do that? The thing will be similar to this. You will be having a base on which your suture will be attached, and then you go for the measurement like this. Now, if there is any deviation in the thickness of your suture, what will happen? The average measurement will be varying. Okay, so if the average measurement is varying, that means whatever the suture has been made, it does not conform with the standards which has been set by the industry people. So there might have been some problem with the processing industry in the processing stage, and that batch has to be discarded. Okay. Now again, this is this is our solution wizard for PILS inspection. Okay. Now this PILS inspection is basically similar to the particle size counting. So what happens? You are having the original image, then you threshold the image, then you add it to the buffer. Okay. So then you go for Danielson this thing. So this comes under advanced morphology, so which we have not discussed in our theory class. Okay. So after this one, it creates a gradient, and it is also used to find out whether there are any there are any conjoint particles. So if you look over here, the conjoint particles, there is a there is a alteration in the architecture. Okay. Now we go for the watershed algorithm. So watershed algorithm is a kind of segmentation which helps in segmenting the background of the image. Okay, it does not do the segmentation of the foreground image. Watershed algorithm. Okay. It goes for the segmentation of the background of the image. In our previous case, in the cell culture, what we are doing, separate objects, we were segmenting the foreground object. But this watershed algorithm, it helps in segmentation of the background of the image. Okay. So see, it has segmented the background. Now, retrieve buffer, then yeah, when you do this thing, so if you see over here, the previously conjoined particles, they have now been separated. Yahan pe aapko theek tarike se nahi dikh raha hai in the projector, but if you look into your computer screens or laptop screens, you will find that they have been separated. Okay. Now, after the separation has been done, you can go for particle analysis. Okay. Now the cell analysis and this both pill analysis, if you see, the idea is same. In one case, what we are doing? In one case, we are segmenting the foreground using the separate object, and in the other one, we are segmenting the background. Okay, so it is not like that. We cannot use this watershed algorithm for the cell cycle analysis, cell culture analysis also. We can interchangeably use both the things. Okay. Now, in this is a solution where we usually go for this tablet discoloration inspection. If any tablet due to some reason it has discolored, it may so happen that these coloring agents, these are being done by putting some edible grade and pharmaceutical grade coloring agents. So it may so happen that due to some reason the color has been discolored. Okay, and due to this, even though all the operation is same, what will happen? There is a probability that it will have some due to the environmental conditions, there has been a degradation of the color. And even though the process is same, process is perfect, due to the use of discolored or the damaged dye, you will get a discolored tablets. Okay, so over here we usually go for the color threshold. Okay, in the color threshold, if you see, there are three planes, HSI. Okay, and color model, we can go for RGB also, HSV also, or HSI. Over here it is HSL. HSI and HSL, they are similar. Okay, now for any color image, we have to do the thresholding in three planes. If it is RGB, we have to have R, G and B planes. I will show you. If it is like this, see, this is in the RGB plane. Okay, you are having red, green and blue channels. You have to threshold it in all the three channels. HSI, again you have to do the thing in all the three channels. So we will stick with HSL. Then we will add it to a buffer. Then we will go for fill colors. Pardon? Here it is not there. There should have been, but it is not there in this thing. Then fill holes. Then subtract from the buffer. Okay, so if you see, remove small objects. So if you see, this discolored things, they have been identified. Okay, then you can go for the particle size analysis of this one, how much discoloration has happened in a particular region. Right? See, this discolored this thing, this has appeared. So this is how the color the knowledge of the color space, they can help you in detecting this information.